to agree by assent number 7 as its element. Okay, so number 8 is what I mentioned before, I'll just repeat it, which is my addition to the original list of recommendations. So I move 1 through 7, and the addition is number 8, any surplus from the £500,000 capital and or the £282,000 revenue funds, which is shown in your pack on table 4.2, be reserved for the library element of any business plans involving the transfer of Brighton Civic Centre following the policy resources consideration of the asset strategy. Is everybody happy to agree that by assent?
Yes,
Councillor
Budd.
Thank you, Chair. Obviously, I support this amendment. It was the expectation all the time was that Bromley Library would be treated the same as other libraries that were to be closed by the council. The community is very disappointed and feels betrayed that that hasn't been the case. As was mentioned by friends of Bromley Library, the Wirral Grove Company had an expression of interest on the site that is still registered on the Land Registry, where it was only relinquished by the council in August. So it seems a bit like the cat was. Community asset transfer was misnamed, it was promoted from the library alone because actually it was only the meanwhile use offer. And without looking at the whole civic centre, it was fairly meaningless. So, and the funding that is set aside for revenue and capital support, the community asset transfers should fairly and equally be available to from the library as well.
Thank you for expressing support for that. I do feel that had the community not been led to believe that they had already managed to fight in 2005 the move to put this asset. And I think we've got to look around the room. None of us were here in 2005. I accept you may have been, but you might not have been in the cabinet. But the community should never have been led to believe that they had successfully fought in something, even if it looks quite percolated leaflet. It was in the Wirral Grove Company. We all know that now. It's only the first time we've been able to say it, but I appreciate your support. So do we agree? I debate by assent as well. Thank you, thanks everybody, that was difficult. We've just got about 40 minutes to get through. I don't want to push the library, it's really important that we look at the hard work that the libraries have been doing. So, despite the budget proposals put forward, despite the cash transfer that we then we tried to do, which did predate the asset transfer policy, which we're trying to sort out now, there is an implementation of a new model, and in your packets on pages 77 to 88, and I'd like to invite Peter Nassbrough to present the report. You have James Roberts and Mark Payne are also in attendance for technical support. But I think we all appreciate that this is, you know, just as if not more important to hear about the service moving forward. Thank you, Peter.
In terms of assets, as you know, new model, it's 4 central libraries, 6 community libraries which are staffed, and 5 co-located RFID or staff libraries, and potential for a new mobile library. Okay, as we sort of discussed earlier this evening, we've carried out a full service delivery until next Monday, 31st of October. Obviously then, as we discussed, the formal library building is considered the community asset transfer process. So we'll be speaking with our colleagues in asset management about how to do that. All the questions around decanting and mothballing, I think that's been covered already. I think one place I just want to sort of highlight, I think it was mentioned earlier by you, Chair, at the beginning, was on co-location. I think that's really important. Strand goes through through this new model. piece I've mentioned about Seacombe Riding, what we've done there, moving the riding to the dual centre. So looking at something similar potentially in Morton and in other locations. So I think that's a really good way to go forward. That's what we're going to look at. As to the strategy, we covered that back in January. It's for Universal Reading for Universal Office. What we've done on that is we've developed a new strategic plan to focus on those priorities. I think in the past what we tended to do is we kind of document it, so it's sat on the shelf. It's really important for us as a service to actually look at those, our strategy, go back to it, see how we prioritise, see how we target, what interventions we can do, and programmes of work, and actually measure more evaluation that's probably not done in the past. So I think that's really important to actually give our life to the strategy, not just have a document that's just going to show. So we want to, we would expect reporting back to this committee regularly on that strategy and how we're doing that. Technology, obviously is really important. I think I highlighted in the report about the staff libraries and how we need to use the new RFID technology. We've had kiosks in place for about 10 years, they need to be replaced. We put a capital bid through to the ICB board on the 26th of September, which was approved. We're obviously subject to PNR and full council, we're hoping to do that purchasing for those new kiosks in those staff libraries. Also, I suppose, on technology is the mobile library, which we've highlighted before. That's currently in scope. I think all I'll sort of say this evening is that the lead-in time from, so we have 12 months lead-in time for procurement to deliver. So this is something that's going to happen until next week. So it's just being aware of that process to actually, if we're a new mobile library, how long it will take. So that's set out in the on the sheet of the appendices, the time scale for that one. Number four, communication and engagement, something again we're working on corporately, just basically to promote our activities. We do all the activities in the libraries, maybe sometimes we haven't promoted them as well as we should do, so we're working with our comms team to make sure that we do that going forward. Number five was information and advice. That's a key function of the libraries. We have the information points, we have the one-stop shops. We're looking at the one-stop shop offer using the appointment system. We've got a video calling group at Birkenhead Central Library. We're looking to roll that out into other libraries. So a new way of delivering that information, which is an important part from the library service. And then the sixth one is sort of service planning, service review, twin track approach. So alongside the new model, we're looking at doing a service review. We're working in the discovery phase for this. So working with colleagues in organisational development to make that to progress that one. So that's alongside the I think that really covers really all within the implementation plan. I think the positive news is that there was a saving of £652k identified, and we are online to achieve that. And that is obviously in addition to the £267,000 that we made on staffing the 2020-21. So I think one target to make that saving of £652,000. And that's it, then, Jack.
Thank you, Peter, and I'm happy to pass on my thanks to you and your team. This was never going to be easy, and the budget situation with the external assurance review falls short of all of your timescales. I appreciate the committee have requested that one-stop shops be included, and you've included that, so thank you. I love a Gantt chart, happy to see a Gantt chart, especially if it has some deadlines, and then it doesn't creep as I'll be preparing different ones for your reports. But it's no mean feat what you're trying to do, and I appreciate, just from a consumer perspective, I've seen the comms look massively improved, but I wasn't really looking at them as closely before, so it's not a good test, but I think the comms are really good as well, and so far I'm really just grateful for everything you're doing, and we're happy to open the floor to questions. Councillor Greer and Councillor Bird.
Thank you for the report. Just on the environmental climate implications, just wonder what's being planned or what's been done so far, looking at opportunities to increase the efficiency and sustainability of the library portfolio, which is in 10.1.
Yeah.
committee on some of this stuff. The mobile library is clearly a significant capital investment at the time, with a lot of economic sort of challenges as well. We're happy to work with the committee on that. And just on Councillor Greer's point around environment, I think as well, the idea of bringing the customer service or one stop shop element into this is because we are moving more digitally and discouraging people to physically attend things like one stop shops because that involves travelling. If we can do this as more of a holistic information and advice service, we cut out lots and lots of journeys both for the staff and for members of the public. There is opportunity here going forward around a lot of that sustainability, and as Pete alluded to, we are included within the sort of scope of the decarbonisation work that we're doing as well. But all that's focusing more on our bigger sites and issues, things like legislators and stuff. So it will kind of progress. But I think, one of the big things we are looking at is those co-location opportunities, because it's only by shrinking the size of the estate. We'll make it more climate efficient if we start putting things together.
Thank you. Councillor Ray.
Thank you, Chair. When we first heard this idea of a mobile library, I was very enthusiastic about it, and I spoke in support at a committee meeting. I have to say I've been having second thoughts, and I know there's no commitment in this resolution to commit to it at this point, and I think that's wise. From all we hear, we're going to face another extremely challenging budgetary round in the coming year. And I really don't feel we need to be committing to a mobile library until we have a clearer picture of the overall finances. Mm-hmm. And the second element I've also got some reservations about, and it links into a question I asked at full council last time, and this was about people trying to contact the council by telephone and getting in touch. The council receives about 250,000 telephone calls every year, and the 6006 number only answers 71% of them. People are not able to speak to an officer and get help on issues that concern them. And I can see the appeal of having these kiosks and the booths and the remote facilities in a handful of libraries around the borough. But most people are not going to want to travel, perhaps considerable distances to get to one of these booths to ask a question. What they really want to do is to pick up the phone at home and speak to somebody. Yeah. And I think we'd be much better off addressing that issue, getting our telephone systems right, rather than investing in this more limited facility, which will not be accessed by the majority of the world's population.
Thank you. Yes, and Nicky just want to come in because it doesn't directly relate to the item 9 that we're on, but I appreciate the point you're trying to make. It.
Thank you, Councillor. So recently, myself and Andy, as a service, have taken over the initial service of the community contact centre. So that's actually moved into our service area now. And the first thing that we were doing to look at this is to develop a customer experience strategy, we'd like to bring to this committee in the new year, because I do see the point, and I've worked in the private sector and customer service for many years, private community and public sector, so I understand that we need to put customers at heart of what we're doing, and we want to limit those frustrations. We are much more digitally enabled now, but the real world is a place where people want to talk to people. So if I can just say that, we note the concerns there. We are also working, a lot of the calls come through. Me, that second point of contact, because a lot of them are revs and bennies, housing, current circumstances and frustrations and worries of people. So we're also working with our revs and bennies team to see how we can move that point two of contact, if you like, when we initially call to explain what the issue is, and then it's passed to a different team. So we need to look at improving that kind of process as well, and signposting information out through our multiple community channels as well. But when people want to have an appointment, you do through our libraries offer and some of our leisure offer, like you could be local, for example, you can book an appointment, and we have been doing exit strategies at those sites and surveys, and we're getting positive results there because people now have an appointment system. So you just need to arrange that through going to one of the libraries and arrange that, as well as contacting to arrange an appointment. So we're trying immediately to mitigate, and as I say, our plans for strategy, and it falls under the remit of this committee, so we'll come here for your discussion and debate.
Great, thanks. And we've kind of covered that off in the work programme. It'll be something we'll add to, which will be the next item, because we're just up against the clock, Councillor Williams.
Yeah, again, yeah, just wanted to thank Alan for making those comments and appreciate the, I think that is one of the issues, the community and communication, and also, you know, there's so many people out there that are really digitally excluded, and I, you know, receive these comments all the time from constituents and really frustrated. And I know I do want to, you know, highlight what a great job, you know, the team do, but as you say, we do really have to make ourselves more, you know, despite, we all know the elephants in the room, the finances and everything else all the time. But as you say, it's so important that we are, you know, available, you know, that officers are available to people, because it really is an ongoing frustration that everyone knows. But very supportive of those comments, and so we want to. I also want to highlight what a fantastic job the staff do on the search board under the most difficult circumstances. They're absolutely fantastic, the staff there. I don't know whether, you know, as you say, there's many problems all the time when we're going to be doing communication for a whole number of reasons. But they go that extra mile, the switchboard staff, all the time, and we're just excellent, you know. Thank you many times through various channels. Thank you.
Thank you, yes, it's an important contact point in the libraries. Just to come back to the implementation of the new model, thanks for the report, I understand it's an initiative process. I certainly have had emails from fans and family members who are made neighbours who are delighted that you can go on the Libby app and the Borrowbox app, and you seem to get a duplicate application. And if you also go into the library, so for those avid readers out there, it seems like there's no end, no limit. If you download both apps and you also go and order physical copy, well, you seem to be able to have, I think this person I will not name is racing through about 15 books in about 10 days.
Just once I chair, you know, we have invested a lot of money in that over the last few years, and there are, yeah, there are circumstances you can do that, you know, if you're familiar with it, yeah, so it's, and obviously the main thing about that was with the, you know, the e-books is they don't, you know, they going forward, you know, they kept there, you know, they don't deteriorate the same way, you know, so it's something, and we've always sort of said, we don't see that, as, you know, as a, instead of the physical side, it's just, you know, to complement us really, you know, so it's something we've looked at again, and obviously, the, you know, books at e-magazines, we'll never look at e-newspapers, so I think that's the way forward, and as, you know, as Councillor Williams has said there, you know, so technology's got to be the way forward, and we're looking to make sure we keep up with everybody else, so,
Thank you. And yeah, just on a personal note, the Intellectual Property Office service at the heart of Birkenhead Central Library saves me the toll fee, because I was a frequent visitor over in the Central Library Liverpool, so thanks for that. So I think the launch went well as well, didn't it?
Really well, yeah. I think it was a piece in the Metro last week that we could see this at all, you know, but it's a very, very compliment to be here. Working with the Chamber of Commerce, I think that's what we need to be doing, you know, from the business side. It's important for both of our areas. And that BIPC is something that's been really good at potential we can roll out elsewhere. Thank you.
Okay, thanks. So the recommendations we have is to go to consider the proposed new model implementation plan and the progress made since the committee in June 2022. I am happy to propose that. Do I have a second of my comments? Do you agree by assent? Yeah, so item number 11 is the work programme, and just on the back of what Councillor Bray raised there and also raised before council. I think we need to add to this work programme, and I wanted to just broaden out what you're alluding to there. So I'd like to propose that in addition on the work program we currently have. I understand that the dedicated revenues and benefits contact team received an unprecedented number of calls, and a new team was established to deal with inquiries for the energy rebate. However, I'd like this committee to review the effectiveness of Council's customer and community contact and scrutinise all the key performance indicators for our contact services as well as advice and transaction services. So the committee can look at the look at this as Nikki's alluded to, but also we need to be confident in Nikki's skills, because it's not just any CRM approach we might take. And so I'm really confident she's able to make a difference there, because if you can book an appointment, you're not left on hold. So we all have a responsibility here to also help people to understand, book an appointment, otherwise you will be, unfortunately, sometimes on hold. And so we all have to agree that addition to the work programme. I'm happy to propose it to a second, Councillor Bray, a second on that one. And that, on 2057, brings us to the end of our meeting. Thank you very much for your patience. Thank you.